If I look at the value for me as A between cooperating and defecting in this first column, it's minus 1 versus 0, right? Which number is bigger?
0.
Right. If I look at it in this column, it's minus 9 or minus 6. Which number is bigger?
Negative 6.
Right. In both cases, defecting is better than cooperating. So in fact, this choice, this strategy dominates the other. In other words, it is always better for me to defect than cooperate. So I will never cooperate, ever, because it's always better for me to defect.
So fine. So I'll never cooperate ever. That'll show you.
By exactly the same argument, minus 1 versus 0, minus 9 versus minus 6, defecting is always better. B will never cooperate. What's the only thing that's left?
Pain.
Pain. This is called the prisoner's dilemma.
Huh. You said it was simple, but it seems kind of evil.
I didn't say it wasn't evil. Those things aren't opposite of one another. It's not like perfect versus hidden or pure versus mixed. It's not easy versus evil. Evil's often actually easier.
It's easy and evil.
So we're in a little depressing place here, Michael. You claimed in the beginning, and I agreed with you, that this is sort of the best option. You want everyone to cooperate because that's sort of what's best for the group. But because defecting dominates cooperating both for A and B, you're going to end up here, at least if you reason about it that way.
Yeah, I see that.
Hence, prisoner's dilemma. The only way to break this is if somehow we could communicate and collude with one another so that we could guarantee that we would both choose to cooperate at the same time.
So that wall, mm-hmm. What if you put a Skype connection between it or a Google Hangout?
Well, if you were forced to say what you're going to say at the same time or somehow be able to punish someone maybe for, you know, not doing the right thing, then you might be able to make a different decision. But for this very simple version where I'm going to do it once, even if I could hear what you had to say, if one of us, whichever one of us went first, the second one would always be able to take advantage of that.
I do find this kind of depressing.
Yes, it's a dilemma. It's a true dilemma. So this brings us to a more general sort of strategy. This whole notion of strict dominance works in this case, but you can imagine very complicated large matrices where it may not work. But it turns out there's a generalization of this notion of dominance that works remarkably well, and that's what people tend to use to try to solve these kinds of games to find out what the true value of a game is. So let me describe that for you, okay?
Okay.